His remorse is boundless. Everything he knew, everything he cherished, is no more. Mighty Indus was never this mighty before. The raging flood, aggravated by torrential rains, has swept all in its path, leaving behind nothing but disaster in its wake. Not since 80 years has there been anything this extreme. And now the tears threaten to drown his last remaining hopes. His life and the lives of millions of others have changed forever. It is a truly horrifying spectacle of nature's unforgiving fury. Its path of destruction burst out from the district of Miyawali and spread to Khoshab, Diji Khan, Rajanpur, Rahimyar Khan, Muzaffargarh, Leya, and Bhakkar, and rivers of torment grievously affecting people, land, livestock, infrastructure, and public buildings. The suffering of people is magnified by the all-encompassing nature of the disaster. The initial feeling of panic from the flood later turns to desperation when they see their sources of income being ruined, when they can no longer travel freely, when they think that they can no longer return to their homes, when their loved ones are lost. It is a feeling of helplessness. In Punjab alone, the flood has taken many lives. Incalculable number of livestock. Over 500,000 houses. Over 3,000 villages have been severely damaged. The devastation has spread to vital infrastructure such as roads, bridges and irrigation networks, and engulfed schools and public buildings. The towns of Kalabaul, Qamar Mishani, Isa Khail, Dera Din Pana, Kot Addu, Jampur and Mittenkot have been completely submerged. In a word, it's a catastrophe and they need swiftest possible help now. Every segment of Punjab society has come together with great determination and sacrifice. Without wasting any time, the Punjab government has acted immediately to save lives through strengthening of spurs and banks and evacuation of people in the shortest possible time. The army, police, rescue, 1122, civil defense and volunteers have been deployed. They are at the front lines, heroically fulfilling the relief effort. Citizens are selflessly donating for the cause. Relief camps have been set up for distributing food, dry rations, medicines, bottled water and tents. Every ounce of strength, every fiber of our bodies is pledged to the curtailment of the crisis. Yet, the scale of the disaster is far greater than anything seen before. Up till now, the Punjab government has borne the entire expense all by itself for the relief efforts in its affected districts. The extent of the destruction considered, much more still needs to be done. Many more people are still beyond the reach of the relief efforts. The suffering people need your help. It is our cause. And it can be yours. Human suffering has no boundaries, no religion, no caste, no creed. Let's join together to save and rebuild their lives for a better future.